Welcome to another session of Cellular Mobile Communication, Unit 3, Interference Topic. Here today we discuss about first example, how to design antenna system. Here for this example one, we had to take omnidirectional antenna system. Under omnidirectional antenna system, in omnidirectional antenna system is nothing but which radiates power equally in all directions. What is meant by omnidirectional antenna system? Which radiates power equal in all direction. How many main lobes of omnidirectional antenna system? There are two main lobes of omnidirectional antenna system. Right. Here for the design considerations. Here we have to design an omnidirectional antenna system in the worst case. Worst case. Here, what is my worst case here? The worst case is nothing but the mobile unit will receive the signals, right? Strong interference from all interfering cell sites. Nothing but we are getting interference. That is the mobile, whichever mobile unit is a mobile receiver, we can receive the interference signals from the all cell sites. All co-channel cells. Suppose I have to take a first type concept. Suppose from the center cell, how many number of co-channels in the first type? 6 co-channels. Nothing but from the first, strong interference from the all interfering cells. Nothing but from 6 co-channels, we are getting interferences. The second worst case is weakest signal from its own cell. That is, we are getting very less signal strength in the one cell. That is the worst case. That is, the design of a omnidirectional antenna system in a worst case is nothing but we have to receive the interference signal from the co-channels and weakest signal from the own cell. Here, based upon this condition, we have to go for one problem. Wait a minute, my PPT is not working properly. Right? See this one. We have to know the concept of first layer concept. Wait a minute. Right, from the first layer concept, from the center cell whose frequency is f1, from the based upon the k equal to I square plus ij plus j square, and based upon the i values, we have to check where exactly the same frequency is available. That is based upon these co-channels. How many number of co-channels from the center cell? 6 co-channels. You know how 6 channels are coming, nothing but the shape of the cell is hexagonal shaped cell. How many faces of hexagonal shaped cell? 6 faces. That's why we are getting 6 co-channels in the first tier. Suppose, what is the distance between the co-channel? Right. In first tier, we discuss about from the center cell and each co-channel, we have to assume that equal distance. That distance is called the frequency reuse distance. At that time, we had to assume that all frequency reuse distance are same, which is equal to d. but in practical it is not possible same distance, not in same distance. From center cell, one co-channel is nearest to another co-channel is from far distance, like this. That's why here in this one, we are taking from this center cell to first co-channel D. The distance between these two co-channels are D. From these two co-channels are D plus R. These two co-channels are D plus R. Suppose this is about D. Again, this is D minus R. This is equal to D minus R. That is different distances we are taking. Different distances. Suppose R is R here. Coverage radius of each cell. Coverage radius of each cell. Suppose we have to assume that the frequency reduced distance D equal to 10 kilometers. Frequency reduced distance is 10 kilometers. And R value is 1 kilometer. That is, each base station can support transmit coverage 1 kilometer distance. D equal to 10, R equal to 1 kilometer. And how much distance between the center cell and this cell? 10 kilometers distance this is. What about this? 11 kilometers. This is 11 kilometers distance. This is about 10 kilometers. This is about 9 kilometers. This is about 9 kilometers. Different distances between center cell to co-channels. This is practical one. This I am taking D plus R, D minus R, some different relations. Here from this, how to calculate C by I ratio? You know the formula. Here, how many co-channels are there? 6 co-channels and 6 interfering sites show in figure. And what are the distances? 2 distances of D minus R and 2 distances of D and 2 distances of D plus R. We know the relation. C is inversely proportional to 1 by R power gamma. R power gamma. R C is proportional to R power minus gamma value. Right, that is coverage. That is power. How much? Based on power only, it can depend on coverage radius. That is power, the coverage radius. The relation is there, C and R. And interference depends upon frequency reduced distance. That's why C is proportional to R power minus gamma and I is proportional to D power minus gamma, which is equal to 4 value. Because of mobility propagation rule of 40 dB per decade. Right. You know the calculation of C by I. C by I, which is equal to R power minus 4 divided by I, as depends upon summation I equal to 1 to 6, equal to 1 to 6, right? D power minus 4. Based upon this relation, we know the calculation already. We discussed this calculation first unit. At that time, we are taking all distances are same, but here the distances are different. That's why we are taking two. How many D minus R distances? There are 2 D minus R distances. How many D distances? 2 D distances. How many D plus R? 2 D. That's why R power minus 4 divided by 2 into D minus R power minus 4 plus 2 into D power minus 4 plus 2 into D plus R plus minus 4. You know the frequency reuse, reduction factor. Right? Frequency reduction factor. What is my frequency reduction? Frequency reuse reduction factor R. Co-channel interference reduction factor, small q or capital Q, whatever it may be, which is equal to D by R. We have to separate from R from this relation. That is, we are getting 2 in denominator, 2 into D by R minus 1, power of minus 1, and 2, right, D power minus 4, plus 2 into D by R plus 1, power minus 4. Once the R is taken as a common, not only R can be, R power minus 4 can be neglected. Then automatically we can where which is equal to 1 by 2 into q minus 1 power minus 4 plus 2 into q power minus 4 plus 2 into q power plus 1 minus 4. We are getting finally. Right. Suppose k equal to 7. We had to assume that k equal to 7. K equal to 7. Then what is going to be q value? Q value, which is equal to d by r, which is equal to root 3 k, root 3 into 7. That is root for 21. We are getting the final. We are getting Q equal to 4.6. Then substitute 4.6 in the above equation. That is, suppose that substitute 4.6 in this above equation. That is, we substitute 1/2 into 4.6 minus 1 power minus 4 plus 2 into 4.6 power minus 4 plus 2 into 4.6 plus minus 4. Finally, we are getting 54. C by value into is equal to 54. Then it converts into dB. We are getting 70 dB. Now I have to go for again some standard conditions. How much we are getting now here? C by I is less than 18 dB. We are getting 17 dB. It is less than 18 dB. Then automatically we are getting interference. We are getting interference. Suppose we have to assume the interference. That is, the conclusion is we are getting interference. Suppose here in this figure, instead of different d plus r, d minus r, so we assume that all the distance are which is equal to d minus r value. This is d minus r, this is also d minus r, d minus r, d minus r, d minus r. That is, all six are d minus r. Then what is the equation we are getting? C by I, which is equal to r power minus 4 divided by 6 into d minus r power minus 4. We are getting 1/6 into q minus 1 power minus 4. Substitute q equal to 4.6 because k, we are taking k equal to 7, which is equal to 28. How much we are getting? 4.7 dB. But we are, it is also less than 18 dB. Nothing, but we are getting interference. Right. Right. See this one. Here initially, we are taking different distances. That is d plus r, d minus r. 2 times of d, 2 times of d plus r, 2 times of d minus r. Finally, we are getting how much? 70 dB. So we are taking all distance r equal, which is equal to d minus r. We are getting 14 dB, which are very, very lower than the 18 dB. It is nothing but we are getting interference occurs. Interference occurs for k equal to 7. How it overcomes? We had to increase k equal to 9 value. Whenever we had to increase the k equal to 9 value, nothing but we are getting I and j values are changed and frequency reduced distance can be changed. Right? Here, see this one. Suppose we have to take k equal to 9, q equal to 5.2, we are getting. So we are, okay, we are taking k equal to 12, we are getting q equal to 6. The substitute in the above equations, we are getting more than 18 dB. And then it satisfies, right? See this one, suppose the previous equations, suppose we have to substitute k equal to 9. The final we are getting C by I equal to 84.5, we are getting 19.25 dB. It is greater than 18 dB, it satisfies. There is no Koch channel interference. For k equal to 12, we are getting C by I, which is equal to 179.33, which is equal to, in terms of dB, 22.54 dB. 54 dB, nothing but here there is no co-channel interference occurs. See this one, this is about a pattern of q equal to k equal to 9. This is a pattern of k equal to 12. See this first figure, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. After this one, again we have to go for base of condition. We have to check where the exact the frequency is applied. See this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Again, we have to go for some different distances. We have to fix the safe frequency. As the k value increases, then our Koch-Aiken interference can be decreases by using omnidirectional antenna system. Is there any drawback here? Based upon the k value increase only, we reduce the Koch-Aiken interference. It is the main drawback. That is, whenever k value increases, nothing but we have to give frequency, different frequency or different cells also increases. Suppose k equal to 7, how many number of frequencies are used in that cell structure? Only 7 frequencies. For k equal to 9 frequencies are we want to use different base station. K equal to what? 12 frequencies structures. As the k number increases, the frequencies are number of frequency cell allocated to the particular base station increases, and Cochan interference reduces. And it's a mind rubber. To overcome that one, we have to go for direction analysis system. We discussed in Monday class. Thank you very much. To our today, I attended the class. Do you have any query? Type your query in a chat box. In assignment also, I am giving some problems. I am giving some distances. You have to solve the C by I ratio and give the conclusion for that one. So all of you, for the solving that problems, all of you note down that how to solve that problem. First of all, you have to data from the problem. First, you have to draw the structure, the other cell layout structures first. Then solve the problem and finally give the conclusion. Without a figure, it is not a exact solution. First of all, draw the figure, solve the solution based on formula, and give the conclusion. Three steps must required for each and every problem in assignment 3, right?